that was the turning point that said to me, this is what I love about architecture. This is what I want to do in architecture. And I thought, well, you know what, I remember that moment. And that moment was in fourth year, just before the Rome term. We had the studio at Rome, and I did the grand tour. And I went all over Europe, and the building that I had the most visceral experience with was this one here. Of course, you know it's the Rome Shone Hall, the Museum. And for those of you who haven't been there, it's this prolonged procession through the building. You see it in moments. You go up a huge hill, and you actually, I'm sorry, I only had this one picture of you from my laptop guy, but you actually enter on the left, and you walk around the building, and the building, as you're walking around, transforms. It's a sculpture of the round, it's poetry, it's you know, if you walk around it, it looks like a nun's hat, it looks like there's things that look like ships, and there's things that look like the clear stories look like mother and child forms, and as you go in, there's this heavy ceiling that looks like you're underneath the boat, or is evocative of being underneath the boat, that lifts as you come up to the altar. And by the time I actually got to the altar, it was about 11 o'clock, and the light was coming through a single window, and the light hit the cross perfectly. It was such a powerful moment for me. I knew what architecture could do, and I nearly wept. It was just so powerful and so memorable. And that became the essence of what I wanted to do in architecture. It was to, for me, architecture is about creating a narrative. It's about engaging the participant on emotional, intellectual, physical. So we actually lived in the back room at the time. So that project actually led to what we found is that the clients, and it was serendipitous, our clients would come to our space and say, you know, we're going to buy some artwork or rent some artwork. But who designed the space? And you know, I would say, well, you know, I did. And then that's how it all started. One of our clients, other clients said, well, you know, I have three partners. We have a multimedia company. We're going to get big. And if you get big, I'm going to hire you to our offices. And I was like, sure, you know, of course. And within like half a year, he got really big. And he started designing websites, and websites were only a few knew how to do it, and always were run by 21-year-olds or 18-year-olds, and they were making a lot of money. And so they got huge all of a sudden, designed his first office, and then it just all happened from there. And it just goes to show, take a chance, and you never know what may happen. So from that project, this one came up because somebody had seen the first. And this one was for a young man who was an optometrist and traveled from Italy, and he thought there was this interesting combination of trades or businesses where in Italy you had eyewear with cameras, for example. And he had this idea that it would be great to have an art gallery, which was all about seeing, and an optometrist. Together. So on the left would be where you could sell the frames, and on the right would be the gallery. And in the center would be these tables that are suspended from the ceiling that can be moved and ordained together at either ends of the space for loading, so they can be pushed out of the way. And one of the things about the design was that that back then, eyewear stores were like, full of like, millions of glasses, and one of the things that I didn't want to do. Edited, so to speak, and just have the frames in one single slot. You see that we left this one. We also did the branding for him. We designed every single element because this was like fantastic for me. I was like, oh, now I get to do whatever I want. So I designed, you know, everything from the tables to the